Good evening. I'm Chris Hasnauer, along with
Miranda Vallee.
And welcome to the initial episode of the 8th season of Washington Township's Monthly Rewind.
Monthly Rewind is a news program devoted towards being accurate and amusing. We're all dedicated reporters who put time and effort into every segment.
Nevertheless, with some new darling faces, we hope this season will be a successful one. So let's get Lucky Season 8 started off with a bang.
Can you hear that coming in the air tonight? It's the WTHS marching band. Colleen Kay amplifies the story.
Years of Chapter 1 championships, 1998 Rose Bowl participants, and an invitation to the 2004 Gator Bowl. It's no wonder the Washington Township Minuteman Marching Band wants to continue their tradition of excellence. The band, however, has recently experienced a change of atmosphere. Mr. Crigliano, a course teacher here at WTHS, took on the additional responsibility of band director late last school year.
Well, the transition took a lot of time at first. There was we started in the summer with some summer rehearsals, and there was amongst the students a lot of, I don't know if this is going to go in the direction, you know, I feel that it should. And everybody was kind of not really ready to make a change. But then once we got to band camp and we hit August, everybody was like, hey, this is going to be a fun time. This is going to be a good program.
After the previous band director transferred schools, Mr. Crigliano stepped up to take on the arduous task of teaching music, marching, and township pride, among many other things.
Pretty much I'm responsible for overseeing the entire program, from making sure I have a accomplished and capable staff to teach the students, and then to just run a lot of the behind-the-scenes things, from getting the buses, getting the competition scheduled, all of the paperwork that's involved, getting classrooms and getting field usage.
With great music, a great show, and great students, Mr. C is expecting nothing less than an amazing season.
For the band to come together, to play together as a team, and to work together, rebuilding the program and putting the best product possible out there on the field.
I also got a chance to talk with some of the student leadership to find out what qualities they think Mr. C brings to the program.
His positive energy and his work ethic. He always pushes us to work hard, and he's always working hard himself. He never stops.
Pride, number one, definitely.
He's brought a lot of determination, and he's brought everybody together. And, like, we're more of a unified band now.
Although there has been quite a change these past few months, the students in the band are still expecting great things this year.
I want us to do really well and go to the Gator Bowl and have a good performance and just win a lot of competitions and have fun.
I just want to have the best show we can as fast as we can. Normally we just rushed right into things, and now we're really taking time to learn how to learn a good show.
I think by the end of the season, and that's one of our biggest goals, is for everyone to come together, not just as a band, but in like the same mindset of where we're going.
Although the Washington Township Minuteman Marching Band program has changed hands this season, both staff and students are expecting to have an amazing year. Reporting for Monthly Rewind, this has been Colleen Kay.
Soccer. It's big in Europe, Africa, and the heart of township girls. Erin Bollendorf tells us about girls' soccer.
Once again, the WTHS girls' soccer team is off to a great start. This time, they are headed by Mr. Shane Snyder, their brand new coach. With the help from Mr. Alvaro, they are sure to have a great season.
I talked to some of the girls and some of the coaches and asked what they thought about the rebuilding season, Mr. Snyder, and their goals.
I think Mr. Snyder is a great coach. He makes us work really hard and keep up our intensity. I think he really wants us to work hard on and off the field. Actually, this year we started something new, and we have study halls like 2 days a week.
We work harder. We go hard. He runs with us. He plays with us. We're learning a lot of new things.
With a school this size and as much ability as the girls have, I would not say that it's a rebuilding year. A lot of talent is returning from last year's team. A lot of talent graduated, but I feel as though the seniors that are left and the juniors and the incoming sophomores are able to step up and contribute. I don't see it as a rebuilding year. I see it as trying to build on last year's success.
I don't like the word rebuild because you're at a school like Washington Township, but I think we just reload. I think it's going to always be that way in girls soccer, and you know, that's the way it is. We may be young, but our girls are good enough, and we proved that at the beginning of the year that no matter how young we are and how many girls we lose, we'll always be a force to be reckoned with.
Potential to go all the way this year. We almost made it last year, and we have more girls moving up and a new coaching staff and new leadership.
Hopefully this year we'll win conference again, and I think he'll coach us to the championship.
I believe we're going to win back-to-back conference championships. I always think that way, and I think it's going to be up to the girls to go out and just do it on the field.
My personal goal is just to improve each game, and by the end of the year playing our best soccer.
Well, rebuilding season or not, it looks like the WTHS girls soccer team is going to have a great season. With their new coach, Mr. Shane Snyder, they're sure to go all the way. Good luck, girls.
And this has been Erin Bollendorf reporting for Monthly Rewind.
With new freshmen for our halls and new freshmen for our lockers, Frank DiLeonardo opens the door to the class of 2007.
A new bunch of freshmen enter our building. No matter who you are, a prom queen candidate or Christian Clark, you remember your freshman year. Monthly Rewind in the past has covered the freshmen. So it's up to me to find out what's up with these new freshmen.
What do you like so far about freshman year?
Well, I like there's a lot of people here, all my friends. Miss the guys are cute.
Meeting new people, different activities.
The girls.
Really like the girls.
And the girls. The girls are really hot these days.
How do you feel about the class size?
Well, there is a lot of people in our class, but I don't think it's that big of a deal to me.
It's not that bad. There's a bunch of people in my class, but everything is all right.
I think a lot of different people allow for a lot more opinions.
I can live with it.
I can live with it.
Now, we know what the freshmen think. Well, what about the administration? What do they think about the class of 2007?
It's a large class, but speaking, I think, on behalf of the counselors and the administration, I think the counselors and the administration are doing as much as possible to make each incoming freshman feel at home and very comfortable in their surroundings.
This year is my first full year here at Washington Township High School. I started in January last year, and this year I get to work with the freshmen, which is new and exciting for me because I'm new and they're new to the high school. So what I hope to do is help them feel at home and welcome like I did when I came here in January, and help them out with any problems they might have with academics or socially with teachers, parents, friends. I also like to help them get involved in activities. Yes, I'm grounded. Our freshman class this year has over 840 students in it. It's one of the largest, it is the largest population of freshmen we've ever had at Washington Township High School. So they made history this year. Since the freshman class is so large this year, class sizes have gone up in each area. Say the English classes are a little larger than usual, the science classes are larger. A lot of teachers have volunteered this year to take on 6 classes instead of 5 classes so that the class sizes could be reduced.
The freshmen and the administration seem to be fine with everything, but can a class of 900-some students get the same attention as a smaller student body at another school? Well, I hope so, but what do I care? I'm a senior. This is Frank DiLeonardo reporting for Monthly Rewind.
The great Interact leader, Ms. Cindy Nolan, has passed in a WTHS legend. Mrs. Naval, the new head madam of Interact, be remembered in the same way? Mike DiMatessa informs us on the new leader.
Washington Township's well-renowned service club, Interact, has been in our school for over 20 years, under the direction of former science teacher, Mrs. Nolan. This year, following Mrs. Nolan's retirement, the club has undergone a change by taking on a new leader. Mrs. Naval has been teaching here at Washington Township for 4 years and seems very happy to be taking over Interact. The club is one of the largest organizations in the high school, and running it can become an overwhelming task.
We're just going to keep plugging away, and it is, you know, takes a lot of time to do this. The kids are great, and they work hard, so I'm just going to try and keep up with them.
Interact is known throughout the high school for its various events, such as the Pace Setters Dances, the Buds Walk, Festival of Friends, as well as the annual Toy Drive. Although they will still continue to participate in these events, this year Mrs. Naval would like to add a new one.
One new thing we're going to do is going to do something to benefit ALS, which is Lou Gehrig's disease. I would just like to do something that would help in the research for that.
Apart from the addition of another event, the new advisor will most likely have an effect on the way the club is run. I talked to some of the Interact members to see how they think Mrs. Naval's influence will change the club.
I think Mrs. Naval is going to add a lot of different things to the club.
She's well organized, and I think she has a few good ideas.
Organization, because we need that, because Mrs. Nolan was good with dealing with lots of disorganization, because most of the stuff was in her head anyway. So now we're trying to file everything, all the information that we need, so we can have it for future years.
I don't know how many changes I'm going to make. I want to try and get as many people involved and keep them involved and maybe come up with some new ideas for service that are a little bit different.
Mrs. Nolan has ran the Interact Club very successfully for a long time. So, as the new leader, Mrs. Naval will have a lot to live up to.
Well, I think it's impossible to fill her shoes, but hopefully I'll make a mark of my own.
The Interact Club has already had a taste of what changes the year will bring. And as for Mrs. Naval, she seems to be well-liked.
Mrs. Naval is very, very nice. She's very kind.
I think she can help the club really well.
Being a teacher of special education, Mrs. Naval enjoys helping the mentally handicapped. But she also says she enjoys staying after school with Interact and getting to work with all types of students.
I wanted to have a chance to work with different kids than what I've worked with in the past. I am a firm believer in service, and it's just getting more involved in the school. I've been looking for opportunities since I've been here to get more involved, and when this came up, I said, let's go for it.
As you can see, Interact is headed straight for another year of successful service for the school and community. Although the new leader will certainly bring about a change, the Interact Club will still continue to make our school proud with all its efforts. We wish Mrs. Naval, as well as all the student leaders of Interact, lots of luck with this upcoming year. For Monthly Rewind, this is Michael DiMatessa.
Miranda?
Dust off your stick and iron your skirt. Field hockey has returned. Dana Graziano brings the new season to light.
The start of the 2003 field hockey season marks the second year for head coach O'Connor. She spent last year familiarizing herself with her team and the division that they compete in. This year, with the help of the seniors, she will use that information to guide her team to a successful winning season.
I feel the team this year is really mine for the first time, because last year I came in late in August and I was kind of thrown into the position and didn't feel like the program was under my control at that point.
With knowledge from previous years and the return of intense players, Coach O'Connor tells us how this year's team will help to bring success.
The players from last year that played for me come back with, I think, even better skill and intensity to really improve the program and to really take a step forward. And we said our big thing this year is, you know, we were knocking on the door last year and it's time to knock down the door. And I think that this team this season is showing everybody how to do that.
I also got the chance to speak with key varsity players on their opinions of Coach O'Connor and their views for this year's team.
You can definitely tell that Ms. O'Connor is more confident with the team. We're more confident with her. We're a lot more comfortable in our interactions.
This year, she has a better knowledge of the players. She knows us better now because she's coached all the juniors who are now seniors for a year. She knows our playing style. She knows our technique. She knows how well we can play and where to play us.
Ms. O'Connor knows our strengths, weaknesses. She knows exactly what to do in practices and stuff. And she didn't come into 50 new faces. She came into about 20 new faces. That's our freshmen. And us as seniors, we really try to help her out with that. And I can definitely see us being more successful.
Ms. O'Connor does a really good job of helping us prepare for our tough schedule. She just keeps us mentally involved. She keeps us hyper. She has a big thing on girl power and all this stuff. She's really cool, though.
Starting varsity players Jackie Cleary and Andrea Squilla shared with me what is done differently this year in practices to prepare for games.
We do more drill work that specifies with what problems we have. If we played the game before and we didn't stay low, then we do drills where we practice staying low. We scrimmage a lot more, which helps us better in the game.
During each practice, we help prepare for the game, the team that we're playing, by doing specific drills and practices that pertain to the team that we're playing.
They also shared how the team will do this year after having knowledge of the competition from last year's division.
I think we should do well against the divisions. Last year we didn't really do too well, but this year we have a stronger program and we have a stronger team, so we should be in tough competition with them.
Last year was the first year we put in a really hard bracket where we had to play each of the teams in our conference twice. And after last year's experience, we've learned a lot of new things and picked up a lot of skills on how to prepare ourselves for each game, and I think we're doing a really good job this year.
Senior captain Jen Shefflin summed up for me her thoughts on Coach O'Connor and the team's unity for this upcoming season.
I definitely feel that this year is going to be more successful because Ms. O'Connor has a year experience under her belt. She's worked with us since last year, all through the summer, communicating with all three of the captains, teaching us what we need to work on with stick work, driving, scoring, and we came back this year closer than ever, working with the coach, being able to score, and we'll definitely get some balls in the net and get the states.
As you can see, Coach O'Connor and her team have high hopes for this year's field hockey program. With a stronger knowledge of her players and a year of experience under her belt, she will help lead this team to a victorious season. This has been Dana Graziana reporting for Monthly Rewind.
The price of student lunch at WTHS has gone up. Why? Chelsea Kerner answers the question.
School year brings WTHS students' favorite period, lunch. I had the opportunity to talk with Washington Township's food service director, Mrs. Jeannie Bowden, along with some of the WTHS students to get their thoughts and opinions on the new increase of school lunch prices.
Amidst these crowded hallways, one can almost expect to hear students groaning over difficult classes and unfair teachers. But this year, issues have been flaring up in WTHS cafeterias and students are looking for answers.
I think the new school lunch prices are ridiculous.
We're paying way too much money.
They're outrageous compared to last year.
It's a waste of money to bring all that money and you don't get that much food.
Washington Township's food service director, Mrs. Jeannie Bowden, explains to students the reasoning behind these increases.
Prices to us have increased, and as I said, we have a new labor contract, so all those things have to be covered.
Of all the complaints, though, one seems to aggravate students the most.
The main complaint is about the fact that you have to purchase French fries separately now.
I think it's ridiculous. We have to pay for 50 cents for fries.
They have less stuff, and they're more expensive.
You don't get chips and fries with the lunches anymore.
But if students feel they are paying too much for lunch prices, I'm sure you must be wondering, how much is too much?
I spend about $25 to $30 a week for lunch.
So $25?
Like $10.
$25, $30.
$10?
Although students may agree that they are paying too much for school-bought lunches, it doesn't seem they will be packing their lunches anytime soon.
Most kids don't want to have to be bothered with that in the morning, and their parents really don't want to either.
I'll still buy it. I'm too lazy to make lunch.
I still buy it, even though it costs so much. I'm too lazy to bring my own lunch, though. So.
Every student interviewed was in agreement of who was picking up the tab.
My parents pay for it.
My parents do.
My parents give me the money for lunch, but they don't give me enough for the prices, so I end up paying some on my own.
Mrs. Bowden made it clear, though, that if one thing is for sure, it is that the students' best interests are always at mind.
Really, all studies show that the lunches you can buy are more nutritious than the ones you can pack. We're trying to encourage healthier choices.
Understandably, students have a negative opinion about the increase in school lunch prices. But thanks to Mrs. G.D. Bowden, students can now realize that the school is willing to take this criticism in order to promote healthy eating habits for the entire student body. This has been Chelsea Kerner reporting to you from Monthly Rewind.
If you ask any senior what the best senior privilege is, 9 times out of 10, you'll get driving to school. Adam Witten tells us more.
You know, Washington Township High School is a very important subject. Many students don't realize that with all the seniors coming and going to school, this creates many traffic problems. The problem is that all of their students have to be bused to school. I recently sat down with students and faculty to see how they feel about seniors driving to school. The first thing you need to know is how many students park at Washington Township High School.
At the present time, we have roughly 500 seniors parking here out of the 760-some seniors we have.
The next question is, why do seniors like parking at Washington Township High School?
Well, personally, I really like parking at Washington Township High School because I personally live across the street, and that way I don't have to walk in the ice and the snow and everything.
I love parking at Washington Township High School because I don't have to take the big yellow bus to school anymore.
I like having to not get the bus or find a ride home. I can wake up later and just drive to school.
It's not bad. There's always some idiots driving around. I was like, but parking lot's not too bad right now. Everyone knows where they're going.
With many seniors driving to school, this creates one big problem: traffic.
I think it's terrible because no one can get in or get out, and I think we should have like an officer to direct traffic before and after school because some kids are late.
I think it's terrible. Every day after school, I have to wait in that long line over there or over there.
There's a lot of traffic when you're going, though, in the morning, and especially when you're leaving school, too. And I guess it's only going to get worse as, like, some sports wind down and you're trying to leave the parking lot during the day.
In the afternoons when everybody's leaving, it does get kind of rough because so many people are trying to leave at the same time.
Mr. Luzio, a teacher at our high school, has come up with a plan to help with the traffic problem.
The thing I wish that everybody would learn is that you let one person go in, you know, at a time, so somebody turns right, then turns left, turns right, turns left. That's the secret.
The big question is, what does Mr. Fields think of senior drivers at the high school?
The seniors this year, I have to say, are a very polite group of drivers, and I don't see many problems here.
As you can see, many seniors at this high school like driving to school, and others, well, they have a different opinion. The one good thing is that Mr. Fields thinks that the senior class is a very courageous group of drivers. With many seniors driving to school, the traffic becomes a very serious issue. All I can say is to avoid most of the traffic, wake up a little earlier, and follow the advice given by Mr. Luzio. This is Adam Witten reporting for Month 3 Rewind.
Now at Township, there are maniacs, and that's for sure, but we're dancing like we've never danced before. Cindy Lou brings the beat.
A new elective was offered to all students in the high school, dance. After a successful first year in existence, the school decided to expand upon this class and add an advanced level. Mrs. Roman and her students offered their input on the program as a whole, as well as their thoughts on the new classroom studio. Mrs. Roman, the only dance teacher here at the high school, was more than happy to accept the job last year.
The dance program is something that had been talked about for a long, long time. Finally just had the opportunity, the district said, okay, go ahead and go with your plans. When this came up, I just couldn't think of a better opportunity. And it was one of those situations like right place, right time. And I was fortunate because they let me write the curriculum for the dance program.
Following an incredible beginning for the dance program, many students moved on to the newly introduced Dance 2 class, and there was also an increased level of interest in Dance 1.
Well, one of the most obvious changes is that the program is growing. Like, the numbers of students are up. We've got 2 levels of Dance 2 and 4 levels of Dance 1. So I had a lot of people that were willing to come back and take a more advanced level, which is great because I can teach more technical things.
It keeps you in shape. From the workout every day.
We have the music, we have everything for everyone. We have singers, we have actors, we have things for everyone. Now it's great to actually have this art form introduced and have everyone who likes to dance rather than just sing or play the music. We actually get the movement part of it now.
I like the new Dance 2 class. We're just getting started pretty much with dancing, so we're not doing that hard of stuff this year, but it's good because we're doing a lot of preparation for our recital, which we didn't have last year.
Perhaps the most exciting thing about the program was that Mrs. Roman and her students had a state-of-the-art studio built especially for their use at the start of the current school year.
The dance studio itself was actually 2 separate classrooms, and they knocked down a wall for me to give us plenty of space.
I think this new studio is absolutely amazing to actually have an opportunity to dance on a real floor, real bars, real mirror, as opposed to last year, we were all over the place.
Last year, I was the portable dance teacher. We spent some of our time on the stage in the CPA, but it was very slippery and full of splinters, and it wasn't exactly an ideal situation.
Especially compared to our options last year, which was the CPA and just going from place to place, it's nice to actually have a place where we can just go every day and know that we're going to dance. And
they got me a really good floor. We have mirrors and bars and a new stereo systems on the way. We even have a piano in here.
Mrs. Roman is looking forward to an eventful school year and has many plans for the near future concerning the program.
We've got a great opportunity. We're going to get to have our first dance concert here at the high school. April 21st. We're very excited because for some of the students it's their first chance to ever get to dance in front of other people, and it's just an incentive for everyone to really, really work hard.
With over 100 students, a state-of-the-art studio, and an upcoming recital, it is obvious that the new program has been a huge hit, and it appears that dance will continue to thrive for many years to come here at WTHS. For Monthly Rewind, this has been Cindy Lewandowski.
Interact is not the only club this year that lost their advisor. The National Honor Society has faith in its new leader, Mr. Lawler. Miranda Vallée reports.
After several years as advisor of National Honor Society, Mrs. Coco retired in the spring of 2003. But with a new school year came a new advisor for NHS, Mr. Lawler. I recently spoke to Mr. Lawler about his responsibilities as advisor, the new year for NHS, and if he could possibly fill the shoes of Mrs. Coco. The National Honor Society is an organization that currently consists of 100 senior members. In January of 2004, new juniors and seniors will be inducted. But until then, Mr. Lawler has his hands full with the current seniors. General membership meetings are usually once or twice a month, at which many different topics are discussed. However, tutoring seems to be one of the main topics.
The NHS members are required to donate their time for at least 5 hours per student to tutor anyone in the school who needs it. There are forms in the guidance office to fill out. So that's one of the ongoing programs that NHS is involved with.
Organizing the January induction ceremony and tutoring may seem like a lot, but luckily Mr. Lawler has a great executive board to help him out.
This year's executive board is incredible. There are 16 people on the board, 14 of whom happened to have been my students last year, and I can't think of a better group of kids to spend every Friday afternoon with for the rest of the year, and I just have the greatest admiration for how hard they all work.
Mr. Lawler obviously thinks very highly of his executive board. But how do they feel about their new advisor?
Well, I've had a great experience working with Mr. Lawler. He was my honors English teacher last year, and that was definitely one of the most enjoyable classes I've ever had.
I like how enthusiastic he is. It's his first year, so he's really excited about it, and he really listens to all of our ideas.
I think he'll be successful. As you know, he's very into being an advisor this year. He's new at it. He's never been an advisor.
I think he's a well-organized person, and he has different ideas, so I think he can do a good job with this club.
It's clear to see that Mr. Lawler is more than qualified to be a successful National Honor Society advisor. From the many NHS events this year to his unending responsibilities, he is sure to rise to the occasion and most definitely fill the shoes of Mrs. Coco. This has been Miranda Vallée reporting for Monthly Rewind.
Bureaucracy is on the decline at WTHS as the great Power School Power Grade program comes online. Chris Hasenauer plugs it in.
Power School seems like more trouble than it's worth, doesn't it? I mean, I'm sure you've heard someone speak negatively about it over the past couple weeks. But what is Power School? And what do the teachers really think of it? I asked around, and with all the negative coverage it's been getting, you'd be surprised at the answers I got. A little confused about Power School? Well, Ms. Farrow and Mr. Greger fill us in a little bit.
Power School is basically our new database program that we're using for the entire district.
Well, Power School is a huge software package that allows teachers to electronically enter grades and attendance, allows guidance counselors to look at teachers' grade books and help students that way, and Anybody with access can check student schedules and other kinds of personal information.
It seems Power School and Power Grade are good for the school, but what do the teachers think?
I think it's a great asset. I enjoy using it.
I haven't had any problems with it.
It's working out fairly well for me.
I talked to the computer trainers, Mrs. Petruzzi and Mr. Greger, and asked them a couple of questions about what the most difficult thing about Power School was to learn.
Probably getting it set up, getting the gradebook set up so that it works the way they want it to work. But after you get over those bumps, it's like most people are so comfortable with it that they don't want to go back.
Again, I think it's just something new, and getting acclimated with the program is the toughest part. And again, once you're past that and you're familiar with it, it's more comfortable.
So do the teachers have any real complaints?
I think it has great potential, but I don't think that Power School or Power Grade was implemented properly initially.
So what is it that makes Power School not work up to its potential? Ms. Carchetti gives us the true story.
The fact that our equipment, the servers here in the building, and actually throughout the district, just were not powerful enough to actually keep Power School up and running and doing its job, what it's supposed to be doing. And that's where all the glitches come in.
Always glitches. We had some things, issues with our servers, and we had to expand them, and the learning curve.
So Power School isn't really that bad of a thing. It's actually a pretty good program, and the teachers love it. The servers just aren't powerful enough to handle all that Power School data. So is a server expansion on the way? That's up to the IT department. This has been Chris Hasnow reporting for WTHS Monthly Rewind.
Kara Rex informs us on the preliminary events leading up to homecoming.
Well, a new school year has begun, and all the seniors are anticipating one event.
Push the tempo, 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 push the tempo.
If you haven't figured it out, homecoming is here, and I'm standing on the track where the magic happens. The boys have voted, the votes have been tallied, and the girls are eagerly anticipating and preparing for this event. But to some girls, it's more than just a contest.
I just want to go out and show our school pride. It's a very positive thing.
There's someone in your school you don't know, you know, get to know that person more.
I think it's a whole popularity thing.
Okay. As they do every year, the boys had a chance to vote and comment on why they love homecoming.
It's definitely because of the girls.
Say, because of the girls?
Well, I think, you know, school spirit's obviously a big part, but I mean, who can forget about the girls, you know what I mean?
Next, I went to investigate on how the counting ballots and voting policy actually worked. For this, I tracked down Mr. Greger, one of the student council advisors.
The ballots were counted by myself and Mr. Spadafore, student council advisors. And each senior boy was allowed to nominate two girls, and then we just tallied it all up and came up with the top 12 girls.
So now that we know about the enthusiasm, the guys, and the voting policy, all that's left is the girls. This year's homecoming court consists of
Tara Bauer, Zoe Carpenter, Brittany DeSico, Bethany Davies, Kristen Flaherty, Megan Hudak, Chelsea Kerner, Michelle LaBelle, Caitlin Matthias, Crystal Sparkman, Amanda Tracy, and Jackie Whitfield. She's from the city of angels, like Betty Davis, James Dean, and Gable.
Never know what she means to me. I feel for the girl that's on TV. As you've seen, homecoming is more than just a contest to the girls, and more than just girls to the boys. This year's competition is going to be a stiff one, so good luck to the class of 2004 Homecoming Court. This has been Kara Rex reporting for Monthly Rewind.
After high school comes college. With our many athletic programs here at Washington Township, participants require more information on how collegiate scouts choose who has potential. Alicia D'Arazio fills us in on the first college recruiting seminar.
students use their junior and senior year as their most crucial year when preparing for college, when in reality it starts as early as their freshman year. For the first time, WTHS held its very own athletic recruiting seminar. This was designed to introduce to students what they may not have considered before.
This is about the truth about college recruiting.
When you ask most students where they would like to go to college, you usually get the same general response: Rowan, Temple, even Rutgers. Jack Rankins tried to enhance the ideas of exploring the variety of colleges rather than just a reputation-based school. Many athletes and their parents went out for this beneficial event in the CPA, and it seemed like they received a pretty good instruction on what to do in the future. Athletes explained to me their reason for attending this seminar.
I'm here because I want to learn more about the recruiting process because I'm planning on playing college tennis.
I was here tonight because I was invited to come, and I'm really looking forward to playing softball in college, and I hope to get in a good college, and I hope that this will tell me how to get there.
This seminar was intended for athletes who would like to continue their athletic career throughout college. Hopefully, this program will come again to WTHS. This has been Alicia Durazio reporting for Monthly Rewind.
With 30 days down and less than 150 left, the senior class of 2004 is our next segment, contributed by Joe DeFoni.
Every year, new seniors flood the halls of WTHS. The class of 2004 are excited and nervous to be back and at the top of the school. I asked them a couple of questions to see what their opinions are and what they're looking forward to about this stressful year.
What are you looking forward to most about senior year?
Prom, probably, or senior trip.
I'm looking forward to homecoming in Mr. Washington Township.
Looking forward to the prom and graduating.
Definitely homecoming.
Senior trip.
A lot more fun and more activities in senior trip.
I'm looking forward to having fun in Mr. Hughes' class.
How is senior year different from the other year so far?
It's definitely because there's a lot of fun stuff to do.
You have no classes, it's much easier.
We have parking spots.
You know why this year's different?
Because we're going to win
this
the championship.
Year we're winning the Group 4 championship, baby.
I don't know. I didn't have a lunch last year, so I didn't get the experience of a wonderful food.
Because it's senior year and we get to go on senior trip.
We're the biggest ones here this year.
What's the worst part about senior year?
That we have to figure out what we're going to do for the rest of our lives.
Probably the teachers and administration.
Really nothing. I think this year's going to be a good year.
The fact that I have to leave at the end of it.
The worst part of senior year would have to be waiting to leave, because just got to get out of here.
So there you have it. The seniors are overall glad to be back, and they're excited about senior trip, prom, and other senior-only events. Sounds like the class of 2004 is looking forward to a great year here at WTHS. This is Joe DeFoni for WTHS Month Rewind.
Sarah Carangelo showcases the many different activities that townshippers engaged in over the summer.
Just as the second month of the 03-04 school year begins, I decided to bring back some memories from last summer. I want the students and staff of WTHS to tell me what they thought of the short summer and what they crammed in that small amount of time. We're going to see who made the money, who had fun, and who kept their education in mind by visiting some colleges. Finally, I'm going to find out from our seniors what they did this summer to make their senior summer memorable.
So now let's get started and see what Township did this previous summer.
We went to field hockey camp this summer and played some more field hockey, and we went down the shore.
Yeah, I went to the shore and played volleyball this summer.
I went to the Warped Tour to see the Used.
I went to Saranac in New York this summer.
I went to France this summer.
Slept.
What did I do this summer? I ate a lot of food.
I played a lot of softball.
Sat around and did nothing else but that.
I went down the shore a couple times with my friends and my family, and I worked a lot.
I cleaned houses at the shore on the weekends.
I worked a lot.
Over the summer, I visited University of Delaware and University of Maryland.
And I visited Syracuse University in New York.
There's mixed feelings among the seniors about their last high school summer.
It
was kind of sad because you don't know if you're going to see, like, your friends that go off to college again. You don't know, like, it's your last summer.
Get it over with. Got one more year.
Just have fun this summer. Just relax and get ready for the senior year.
As you can clearly see, the students and staff at Washington Township High School kept themselves busy this summer. Even though June, July, and August flew by, they still managed to enjoy the time that they had. Those who worked made the money, and those who visited colleges got a head start on fall applications. I got mixed emotions from the seniors because they now realize that this may have been the last summer spent with their high school classmates. Either way you look at it, they're all looking forward to a fun and exciting senior year. This has been Sarah Carangelo, Monthly Rewind.
When the township spends $400,000, you know there's got to be some racket involved. In this case, it's a tennis racket. Jackie Cleary informs us on the girls' tennis team.
The return of the school year means the opening for fall sports, and the 2003 girls' tennis team is well on their way. I talked to Coach Costa and the two varsity captains about what their goals are for the season, who their toughest competitions are, and how they like their new tennis courts.
With all the returning starters from the previous year, the team has a positive outlook for the season. I asked varsity coach Ms. Costa who our key players are this year.
Jamie Wiley playing at one, a four-year veteran at number one singles and co-captain of our program. Kristen Wallace, number two, also a four-year varsity veteran and also a co-captain. Number three, Lindsay Christopher, a junior, playing first doubles for us is Nicole Fasolino and Amanda Fasolino, and playing in the second double spot would be Mallory Tomchak and Kat Jalawaharla.
With the dedication of the players, the girls have high expectations this season. I asked Ms. Casa, along with the two varsity captains, Jamie and Kristen, what their goals are this season.
To go to the state tournament again and go farther than I did last year and to win the Gloucester County Times tournament.
To qualify for states and go as far as possible in the Gloucester County Times.
Expectations this year would be for us to finish pretty strong in the Olympic Conference. We're the Gloucester County champions for 2002. I also expect our team to make the state tournament. We need to have a 500 record by the cutoff.
In order to have a successful team, you must have good leaders. I asked the captains what they hope to bring to the team this year.
A lot of leadership and experience coming back. We have a lot of returning players, so hopefully my experience will help them in the long run.
Attitude and leadership.
With their goals set, the tennis team will be well prepared when facing their toughest competition. Ms. Casa and the captains told me who their most competitive games are against.
Best competition always is Cherry Hill East. They have an unbelievable feeder system. They play all year long and they're club athletes.
Cherry Hill East.
Ashley Harper and Cherry Hill East.
With the new tennis courts installed for girls' tennis, the team is fired up to play this season. I asked Coach Casa how she felt about the new tennis courts.
I love my new tennis courts. I love our new tennis courts. It's been a long time coming. The last time we got new tennis courts was in 1970, when those over there on the other side of the building were built.
With the new tennis courts, returning key players, high expectation, leadership skills, and dedication, the girls' tennis team has high hopes for this season.
Unbelievable feeder system. They play all year long and they're club athletes.
Cherry Hill East.
Ashley Harper and Cherry Hill East.
With the new tennis courts installed for girls' tennis, the team is fired up to play this season. I asked Coach Casa how she felt about the new tennis courts.
I love my new tennis courts. I love our new tennis courts. It's been a long time coming. The last time we got new tennis courts was in 1970, when those over there on the other side of the building were built.
With the new tennis courts, returning key players, high expectation, leadership skills, and dedication, the girls' tennis team has high hopes for this season.
Well, I hope you enjoyed our program tonight.
And thanks for watching. For everyone here at Monthly Rewind, I'm Miranda Valet.
And I'm Chris Hasenauer. Have a good night.
I had the opportunity to speak with Washington Township's Food Service Director, Mrs. Jeannie Bowden.
Then finally, we're going to ask our seniors what they thought of their last high school summer. Oh my God, I did it! You're wearing swooshies!
Good evening, I'm Tony Trash.
Why can't we be friends? Why?
You're walking down to Chinatown. I called you, but you did not look around. Yeah, yeah. I pay my money to the welfare line.
After several years as advisor of National Honor Society, Mrs. Coco retired in the spring of 2003. But with a new school year, it began.
The return of the school year means the opening for fall sports, and the 2003 girls tennis team is well on their way. I talk.
As long as we can live in harmony, yeah, yeah. I kinda like to be the president. The knocker, show you how your money.
15 years of Chapter 1 championships, 1998.
I'm Teddy Sharp.
Sometimes I don't speak right.
This is Adam Whitney, point one.
But did I know what I was talking about? I know y'all
should I put the sunglasses on?
The CIA.
Okay.
They wouldn't have you in.
So go like this?
Is
that far?
Why can't we be friends? Why can't we?
I like choked on my spit or something. Okay, ready?
Why can't we be friends? Why can't we be friends?
Why? Well, I can't see you. It's right there.
Why can't we be friends? Why can't we be friends? Why can't we be friends?
Okay, guys, the part of that's a little cool. I'm going to try to make a picture of Dennis.
I